So we've just finished parametric equations and parametric differentiations. Remember before that we did implicit differentiation? We looked before that at chain rule, quotient rule, and the product rule, and we learned how to differentiate from first principles. We're now going to look at this last section of differentiation, where we're looking at inverse differentiation. Now, basically that means it will teach us a technique of how to differentiate inverse functions, such as sine inverse of x, tan inverse of x, and cos inverse of x. But before we do that, we're going to talk a little bit about what to do if you have a function x in terms of y, and then we'll move forward to the actual inverse differentiation. If we look at our first example, we have a function where we're being asked to find dy by dx. But if you look at this closely, you'll see that this is given in terms of x equals to a function of y. Now, we haven't seen something like this before. We've done y equals to a function of x. We've done x and y as functions of t, but we haven't really seen a function of x in terms of y. Now, usually there's two things that we do. We might rearrange for y if it's easy enough, or we could do implicit differentiation. But if you look at this question, it's a little bit more complicated. We have x in terms of a more complex looking function of y. So we ask ourselves whether there's any way we can just make this a little bit easier and find an easier way to differentiate it. Let's have a look at a technique that we can use to differentiate this function. Given a function x equals to y squared plus 1 and y squared minus 1. Now, we said that there's two things that you could have done. You can make y the subject of the equation, which in this case will be a little bit complicated. You can also take this entire expression to the other side and then use implicit differentiation, which would be slightly easier perhaps. But there is another way of doing this, and that is by just keeping your objectives of finding dy by dx. So remember that what you want to do is calculate dy by dx. What you could do, because you have a x function here, is that you could calculate dx by dy. So you could differentiate x in terms of y. And then, remember, to find your gradient, all you'd have to do is flip this function. So you'd kind of swap the places to change it back to dy by dx. It's quite a simple idea, but it really helps with more complicated functions like these. So what I'm saying here is, instead of you having to rearrange, we could just momentarily say that we're going to differentiate x with respect to y. Remember, we always differentiate y with respect to x, but we can differentiate x with respect to y with the condition that at the end we swap them. So we change, bring dy back to the top and dx to the bottom so that it becomes the gradient. So remember, the gradient is this term here. It's dy by dx. So that's what we're going to be looking at doing. We want to find dx by dy. In order to do that, if you look at your function, it's a function that's being divided by another function. So we need to use the quotient rule. Let's just remind ourselves what the quotient rule is. So the quotient rule states that in order to differentiate dy by dx, we can do v du dx minus u dv dx all over v squared. So this is the rule. We're obviously not doing dy by dx yet, but this is the rule that we use for the quotient rule. So we pick our u and we pick our v. Our u in this case is going to be y squared plus 1, and the v will be y squared minus 1. We differentiate each one of them, so we have u dashed, and now in terms of y, we'll give you 2y. And then we have v dashed is also going to be 2y. Looking at this now, we now apply the quotient rule. So we're going to apply dy by dx. So we're just looking at this definition here. We're going to say v du dx, so we're multiplying this expression with this. So we have y squared minus 1 multiplied by 2y minus u dv dx here. So we're going to have 2y multiplied by y squared plus 1, and then we divide by v squared, y squared minus 1 all squared. Okay, We are going to tidy this up. So if we bring that back up here, let's make this a little bit tidier. So this equals to 2y cubed minus 2y. And then we have another minus 2y cubed minus 2y all over y squared minus 1 all squared. You'll see here that 2y cubed, 2y cubed cancels out because one's a positive and the other's a negative. So we end up with minus 4y over y squared minus 1 squared. Okay, so remember what this is. Initially, we started off by calling this dx by dy, and we've used the formula of dy by dx. If I just relabel this here and put that as dx by dy, because basically we've just differentiated this function here. We've taken the x and we've differentiated dx by dy. I hope this notation in between of the quotient rule didn't quite confuse you. Okay, so we've got our answer here, but remember this is the answer for dx by dy. To find dy by dx, all you have to do is swap places. So the dy comes to the bottom and dy goes to the top and dx comes to the bottom. And so we have to do the same on this side of the equation. We also have to swap this fraction. So we'll leave the minus as it is. We've got y squared minus 1 all squared over 4y. And here you have your gradient dy by dx in terms of y, just by using the fact that we can change dx by dy to dy by dx.